just thank you. I just thank you. Thank you. Thank you for this place. On my way here, I just kept hearing, in the name of Jesus. His name. His name. The power is in his name. And I am just in the car. I'm crying. I'm trying to drive, trying to wipe my eyes and drive at the same time. And then every car in Gettysburg was in my way. Every car. If it wasn't a car, it was a truck. If it wasn't a truck, it was someone holding a sign that said, slow down. So I said, okay, God, okay, all right. I know you'll get me there on time. It was hitting almost 2 o'clock, and I'm like, oh, I gotta get there, I gotta get there. But God got me here on time, just in the nick of time, just like he does. He's always on time, never late, never late. No matter what our time is, our scheduling, God is always on time. My name is Cheryl Tyler, and I want to talk today about the love of God and the family of Christ. The word family is, when I see family, I think of my mom, my dad, my brothers, and my sisters. None of us look alike. And we, as growing up, my brothers and I were kids. Well, I don't know who your daddy is or who your mother is, but I know we are all brothers. And just like with the body of Christ, the family of Christ, we're all brothers and sisters, all of us. If we could just get that in our hearts, get that in our spirit, that it's no separatism when it comes to God. We're all supposed to be coming together to worship him in spirit and in truth, together, regardless of our religion, our sex, our race, how tall or short we are, all of this stuff that man has made up that has set us separate away from one another, and we need to be coming together. I get angry because we try to bring the churches together and they don't want to, and that should not be. That's why I'm so grateful for what Pastor Mike is doing in this place, bringing different ministers in from all walks of life, whatever their race is. You can't, in a lot of churches, you can't come in their pulpit if you're not of their denomination. But with God, there is no denomination except holiness. Only holiness and his love. His love. That's what gets me. He pours his love on us daily. The love of God is with us daily. And yet and still, we hate our brothers and our sisters. We do it all the time, all the time. The love of God gives us another chance. The body of Christ, everybody say, you go ahead and do it. No, we don't want to be bothered with you because you don't worship the way we do. What I have found out, I go to a lot of different ministries. Some people just sit there very quietly in their own quiet way, and that's how they worship. But me, my God made me very rowdy for him. I get so excited when it comes to God. I can't say, okay, yeah, God is awesome. God, no, God is awesome. He's awesome. And I want the world to know it. My God is an awesome God. He's on time. He loves me even when I mess up. And I do. Quite often, I try not to, but day by day, God is removing the junk from me day by day. This is not a one-time thing. It's like a daily thing. He's stripping things off of me that shouldn't be there, that got there over the years, that I allowed to stay. I kept thinking, I don't need any help, but I did. I did. And I'm saying that about the family of God. We need help. We need to let go of all the junk that we've been raised to believe and get into the Word of God. Let the Holy Spirit do a new work in us. That's the only way we're going to come together. The only way. The only way. When we see that our God is a God of forgiveness, then we'll see a new thing happening. When we give the hatred that's in our hearts to God, then we'll see the power of God. Wow. Ooh, Bible. I remember someone approached Jesus, and he was saying, "Who is my mother and my brother and my sister except they do the will of God? Who are they?" And that's what I'm saying. If we have said yes to God to come in, be our master and savior, Lord Jesus Christ, if we have said yes to him, there's a whole lot of other people who have said yes to him as well. So we should be saying, this is my mother, this is my brother. But no, we're saying, no, we don't want to be bothered with you. And that's not God. Sometimes I'm judgmental, and I shouldn't be. I'm just daily asking God to just work on me, because I am not perfect. I'm not there yet. And anybody that stands before you and say that they don't do certain things, I'm not going to say anything about that. But I know God is working in me. God is working on me. And I know God is working on all of you. I know he is. Because this is the only way we're going to make this work. When God allows us to be in his family, when he allows that, he has given us a gift, which is his Holy Spirit. And we take that gift from place to place. We share that gift with people that don't even want to hear God. Sometimes we don't even have to open our mouths, but they know there's something different that's in us. When I go to a restaurant, I can spot another Christian. They don't have to say a word to me. I can spot them because there's something different about them. It's something so bright in them that if I wasn't a Christian, I would want what they have. And that's what the world needs to see in the body of Christ. So many people are turned off because they go to church and what they see on the inside of the church is just like what's on the outside. And we need to turn that around. We need one by one. I'm not going to say all of us at the same time, but one by one. If we could just come together, it would be nothing that we can't accomplish. Nothing. You go through York or any city or any state, you see so many things that are wrong in our neighborhoods, people on the corners, people that are homeless. You know, if we would come together and pray, like the word says, humble ourselves. Humble. That's the word, right? That's the key. Humble. Humble. Stop trying to make a name for yourself, but humble yourselves before God and pray. Pray. Pray for your neighborhoods. Pray for your pastors. Pray for your leaders. Instead of sitting back and complaining, pray. We need to come together. We need to grab one another and hug one another. Tell them, I love you, just like God loves me. We're still learning the lesson of love. We think we got it. We don't. We don't. We say, I love you to your honey or your husband, and they'll say it back to you. But the true love that God shares in us and on us, it is no stipulations. Just come to me. Come to me. Follow me. Say yes. Say yes to Jesus. Say yes to him. And you'll start seeing the things you've been praying about starting to move out or come to you. Whatever it is you're praying about. Your neighborhoods might be in a mess, but if you're not praying, it's going to stay in a mess. It is. We have the power. God gave us the power. He gave it to us. He made us ambassadors. He gave us brothers and sisters and mothers to do this together. Where we might get weak, you can call on one of your brothers and sisters, and they'll lift you up. What Paul said, I think myself happy. I have to do that. A lot of times things get me so bogged down. I have no one to call on, and I have to call on God. I have to. He's a miracle worker. When you think that you can go this way or that way, God is cleaning us up. Because as Christians, We are not to walk the way of the world. We are not. Our standard is not the world's standards. We try to make it that way. We try to fit into the world's standards, but that's not the standard of God. We need to get the mind of Christ. We need to know who our God is, get into our word, meditate on our word, fast and pray. I'm always saying that. We need to fast and pray. People are getting out of the notion of fasting, oh, we don't need to do that anymore. Yes, we do. With me, when I fast, I'm rebuilt. Ooh, woo! God does something different on the inside of me that I couldn't have gotten if I didn't sacrifice some time to him. And if we need to fast in reference to the body of Christ, then we need to start doing it. We need to be calling on the name of Jesus. There's some brothers and sisters that need our help, and we can't get to them. But our prayers, and the sacrifice of praise will bring them or touch their lives. We don't even have to know who they are. If someone says, if you can pray for my sister, pray for my brother, you don't need to know their name. God does. Just pray. Just fall on your knees at that time or when you get home or with that person in the mall, wherever. I was in a restaurant this morning. And we were talking just some business that needed to be talked out. And a waitress came by. I never knew God was going to do anything, because sometimes I know he's going to do something. He lets me know sometimes beforehand. But this day, this waitress said, may I take your plate? Immediately, the Holy Spirit just dropped down into my spirit, and I made a noise. And she said, is everything all right? And all I could do was look at her and just ask her, can I touch your hand? And when I did that, she said, oh my goodness, I got goosebumps just by doing that. Just by doing it. I didn't even say anything else at that point. And then God had given me a message to give to her. And then when she walked away with my plate as we got ready to leave, I saw God still working on her. And I didn't preach to her. I didn't. People get it confused. You have to have a whole sermon in line for when someone comes near. But no, because when God calls you to a certain place at a certain time, the word is already in here. He's already planted it before you got there. And that's what's so good about my God. And the thing is, we are not alone in this. There are plenty of God's people all around the world, different denominations, different races, different cities. If we could come together and share who God is, not only with one another, but with the world. With the world. I thank God for lifting me up when I couldn't have done it myself. I just thank him for going before me every step of the way. I thank God for the manifestation of his spirit in me, because there's so many dry Christians. Dry! Gotta get hooked up. It says, forsake not the assembling of the family of God. Forsake not. If you stay alone, you're just going to dry up and wither. But if you constantly get together, you're going to come back to life. You're going to be like a raisin. When you put it in water, it plumps back up. And I believe that so much, because so many Christians will say, I don't feel like going down to that church today, or I don't feel like coming to that meeting today, or I don't. But that's the only way sometimes we're going to come out of that desert place. We need to connect. We need to touch. We need human life. Sitting in front of TV is not going to do it all the time. It's not. It's good if you can't get out. But there's times you need to be in the presence of God. And you can be in your home, but you need others to be in their presence with you, to lift them up, because you don't know what everybody's going through. And then God has placed people in your lives that are always praying for you, and you don't know it. And that's a good thing, because a lot of times if you know stuff, you will mess it up. If you know someone's praying for you, then you're going to want to know, well, why are you praying for me? What's the reason I'm on your heart? That is none of your business. If God is setting this person or persons or your brothers and sisters in Christ to pray for you, know it's for God's glory. Know it's for God's glory. With me, I am so rowdy sometimes. I just thank God for making me so unique. And that's another thing. He makes us so different. We have all of these different gifts. Yes, God. Same spirit. All of these different gifts. Working this way, working that way. You could have a healing gift. But one person might be healing by laying hands on. Somebody might be healing by singing. Someone might be healing someone by ministering or just walking by. So many different gifts that God gives us. We get stuck on, oh, if it doesn't work this way, it's not of God. How do you know? God, He's the Lord. He's the one who gives these gifts through the Holy Spirit, the working of the Holy Spirit. And if you don't let go of your mess, your junk, you're going to just stay in that position. Personally, I want to advance in God. I want to advance like the troops, all dressed up for war. I want to advance. I don't want to get dressed up and stand still. What is the point of that? If God is dressing me up for Him, for war, then I'm ready to roll. I am ready to do some damage in the kingdom of hell. That's what God has created us for, not to be wimpy and sit back and say, you do it. It's for us to do. He's a mighty God. He hasn't slacked us with anything. He's always there, always doing something good for us, and we don't deserve it. Always. And yet we still complain, murmur, do all kinds of things against God. I'm guilty. I'm guilty. But God, He's my source. He's all of our sources. And all I can say is the love of God will keep you connected, will keep you in your right mind when your mind starts to wander and start looking back, which God is saying, don't look back. Why? Because I'm doing a new thing. I'm doing a new thing. You will not see it if you're constantly looking back. And if He's advancing you forward, then He's going to bring other brothers and sisters to you to help you advance. Encourage you when you say, I can't do this. And they'll say, yes, you can. Because God has already ordained you to go forward. Already ordained you to move in your gifts. Already, whatever your ministry is, He's already ordained that you might not see it. But it's there, it's in you, and at the proper time, God is going to raise it up out of you. And whoever you are supposed to help in your ministry, that person will be right there. I wrote a book some years ago called Walking in the Spirit with the Living God. And a part of that book talks about the world is waiting for you. The world is waiting for each one of us to get our act together. Whatever God is doing in us, He's clearing us out so that the world can receive what God has put in us for them. Oh, whoa, yes, Lord. Wow, mighty God, powerful woman. Woo! Wow, God, I feel that when you walked in. Yes, Lord. Woo! Glory to God. Yes. Woo! Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord. I just thank Him. Because lots of times we don't know what to do. We don't know what to do. I was speaking with a young lady today, and she didn't know what to do. And I said, you must build your relationship with God. Go to God with whatever question you have, because you might tell me or someone else, and they might think it's silly. But with God, He already knows what's in your heart. He can answer you immediately. I can't. Because I'll start to analyze, well, maybe you shouldn't have said this, maybe you shouldn't have said that. But God, He knows the desire of your heart. And He will answer it in a way that you will hear it and that you will understand it. That's the good thing about God. There's no judgment. He's not saying, I'm not going to hold this answer back from you because you didn't do X, Y, Z. You know, I heard the gentleman talking earlier about repentance. We need to do that. We need that. The body of Christ is not exempt. We are the ones that need to be repenting more because we do so much damage to other people. We're hurting each other so much, and it should not be. We're Christians. We are Christians. Oh, God, I just love you, Lord. I love you. Thank you, Lord. So, people look at me like I'm crazy sometimes, and I don't care. I can say I'm crazy for my Lord. I'm crazy for him. I'm rowdy for him. I am ready, Lord. And so many of us are saying, Lord, yes, pick me. It says, whom shall I send? Who? And who will go before me? I'm saying, me, Lord, pick me, pick me. And there's so many other people saying, send me, Lord. I'm ready, send me. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, God. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. With our brothers and our sisters and our mothers, we need to respect one another. We need to do this for the body of Christ because the world is watching us. They're watching us. If we're constantly bickering amongst ourselves and we're supposed to be God's people, how is that going to draw them in? How? It's not. Because we don't want them to be that way. We want the love of God to show that we're grateful, that we're at rest, and that we're at peace with him and one another. And one another. That's hard for a lot of people. That is so hard for some people. Real blood, brothers and sisters, it's hard to get along all the time. As long as you don't keep holding it for years and years, killing your own spirit. And suppose your family members, your real kinship, your real bloodline people are not saved. How are you going to draw them in if your face is always upside down? How are you going to do that? Nobody wants to say, I'm sorry, I apologize, forgive me. Forgive me. Forgive me. That's a big word to a lot of people. Forgive me. I was wrong. Nobody wants to say that. But yet everybody's going to heaven. I'm grateful. I'm just grateful for the changes that my God is doing in me. And if you're here, then he's doing something in you too. I thank you, Lord. Each day that he gives us an opportunity, we need to take it. Because you might be praying, I don't know what you might be praying, but whatever it is you're praying for, and then he opens the way for you to do something, and you get that opportunity. You better not say, well, I don't know if I'm going to do that or not. You've been praying for it. And then God blesses you with it. God always hears our prayers. Always. In the midnight hour. The midnight hour. That's the tough hour. When you can't sleep. You're laying there. Your mind is wandering. You're going back and forth. What should I do? Lord, I don't know what to do. Should I call this person? Should I do that? But God is saying, I'm here. I am with you. I am with you. And we got to trust God. That midnight hour will make you or break you. And it's supposed to strengthen you, to build your faith so that you can see how our God will bring us out. It's not going to always happen the way we think. Okay, we have everything all organized. Okay, now, this is the way it's supposed to happen. Most times it never does. Most times it never does. God is saying, who's in control of this, you or I? And if we decide to let go and let God be greater in us then we will see the miraculous. And that's what I want. I want each one of you to see the miraculous and be walking in the miraculous and in the power of God. Woo! That's what I want. And wherever I go, I'm not ashamed. People don't want you to pray here. They don't want you to pray there. But wherever I go, I'm not ashamed. I will pray for someone in a heartbeat. I don't care if they say we can't mention the name of Jesus in here. Who said so? My Bible doesn't tell me that. Shout it from the rooftops. Woo! Yeah, God. Yeah, Lord. That's who I am. And it's time for the body of Christ, the family of Christ, to start showing love toward one another. Get back to the altar. Get back to the mourner's bench. Whatever you need to do to get back to God, you need to be doing it. Because now is not the time to be fooling around. Now is the time to heighten your spiritual walk with God, to hear what God is saying in these end times, to get that discernment. Because we have these gifts, but they're laying dormant. Huh. We don't even want them to move because we're too comfortable with where we've been and who we are. But God has said, now is not the time for that. I got a higher calling for you. I got a bigger purpose for you. And it's time to let go of yourself. Ooh, it's time to let go of yourself. Mighty God. Woo! Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Just to say Jesus, that's a big word right there.